Alrighty, welcome to this week's funnel tip. This week I have a special guest. I've got Maximilian here with me from Growth Hackers Stockholm. I actually was super impressed. You work with some super big brands, which is, yeah, really impressive. So today, Max is, I'm gonna go with Max, that works, right? Today Max is gonna talk to us about how sensitivity analysis can actually help you achieve your business goals. I think this is a super valuable and super interesting one that's really gonna stretch you as a marketer to really help you hit those goals. So yeah, Max, you wanna kind of kick us off and intro us into what we're talking about?
Sure. Sensitivity analysis is a part of our toolbox for when we do the gap analysis, helping a client to reach the business goals. So let's say the client has 5 million as yearly target, and right now they are only at 2. And then we essentially try to figure out how will we add those extra 3 million. And then that is what we call gap analysis. And for the gap analysis then, we usually start off with a basic funnel, and then trying to figure out which steps of the funnel could we actually increase.
Right.
And then, of course, the first step is traffic in, used by acquisition, ad spend, or SEO. And the other steps are conversions. And then, so we're looking at, are there any of the conversions that we think we could increase where there are issues? With the sensitivity analysis, you essentially plot during an x-axis and a y-axis. So like, what if we increase conversion rate by this much? What would that give output? And then we're looking from an experience and from benchmark to see like, okay, what makes sense here? How much could we increase the different steps? And then do we reach the target? If we don't reach the target, if the sensitivity analysis shows that, well, we're still short, then we need to increase input. Input here would be probably ad spend. And of course, there could be limiting factors that would make that some of the steps are not addressable. Like we couldn't switch out the tools for the checkout, or we don't have developer resources for like landing page optimization or so on. It could also be limiting factors for the traffic. Let's say we could stress test with Keyword Planner or so on that, are there more volume for your keywords? Maybe it isn't, and then we need actually to do conversion rate optimization. Mm-hmm. There is also the last part, which is essentially often overlooked, but could we increase the average order value? Could price be something we could work with here? Are there potential to increase the price and still maintain the amount of conversions? So the funnel is a priority tool to figure out where we can use the sensitivity analysis, and that usually gives you one side, but it doesn't really take into account the whole growth formula, or growth equation, could be the retention and the churn part. Mm-hmm. Most funnels usually looking at just your traffic straight up. It's not discriminating, so to speak, between new and existing. So that could also be a tool to sort of to dig deeper into where the issues lie or potentials.
And I mean, super interesting. I think we're gonna link an article to a bit more detail about the growth equation, because maybe it's a little bit too much detail to go into here, but it is a super valuable part of taking the sensitivity analysis and really making it even more valuable and making it even more accurate, so you can really leverage each step of the funnel. And this sensitivity analysis is really elucidating how you can leverage each, or which part of the funnel you can leverage, which one you need to dig into, which one you need to improve to actually hit your business goals.
Yeah, and it usually helps the stakeholder when we show this to understand, instead of talking about, you know, the conversion rates and A/B tests and the marketing channels, are you talking about, okay, but so you actually have a goal that is 5, but with what you're giving us and with the tools you got and the budget you have, we don't see you be able to reach more than 3.5. Mm-hmm. And then you can have a discussion like, how do we address this? Mm-hmm. Which is usually a lot more efficient. And so you're speaking to the stakeholders on their terms, with business goals and with financial numbers. Which I find really valuable. And this can be used, of course, also, I mean, ongoing, doesn't have to be in the beginning of an assignment, but like when you're doing, when they do new budgets or new goal settings. And I find that this tool is, for us, becoming more and more important as growth hacking and growth marketing is moving into more strategic work, mm-hmm. And where you want to be with where we want to be with our clients.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Listen, that was a really great explanation about an incredibly detailed and also a pretty in-depth topic. I think I want to get people to start thinking more about the strategic side of things, and I think this is a great way to do so. I've started looking into sensitivity analysis. I think that anyone watching, like, it's a great thing to start looking into. And so thank you so much for joining us today from GrowthHackers.com and talking to us about a really detailed topic and making it understandable. So appreciate it.
Thank you, Alexander.
Perfect. That's it for this week's Funnel Tip.